friend to come into this place. God is too good. We do not come here to be discouraged and disconsolate.
Amen.
You look at some Christians in the worship service, you know, you would wonder, what's going on? My Lord, my Lord. We do not come here to display long faces. Frowns and scowls of displeasure. That's not why we come here.
No, sir.
This is the house of prayer. Peace among yourselves, because peace in the churches. Do I have a witness? People who are filled with the joy of the Lord are not judgmental of others. Why? Because their priority is given to ensuring that they are in a right relationship with God.
That's right.
We have no time to be jealous of this one and the next one. And judging this one and the next one. And hating on this one and the next one. The devil is a liar. And then you will have the joy of the Lord.
Yes. Amen.
Oh, praise God.
Amen.
You see your brothers yourself.
Yes.
You see your sisters yourself.
Yes.
In fact, according to scripture, you see them above yourself. Because you esteem others better than yourself. They desire to remove the beam from their eye. Talking about people who are filled with the joy of the Lord. Their desire is to remove the beam from their eye before they condemn the mote in their brother's eye. They desire to share eternal life with Jesus in that celestial city on the other shore. So they have no time to be judging.
No.
And condemning. Listen to the Apostle Paul in the text. Wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only.
Amen.
He organized the church. He started the work. But now he was in another place. That place is called the Roman jail, waiting to be executed. But he says, you've always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence. What a powerful testimony! There were not man pleasers and eye servants. The man is in jail, and they're still faithfully carrying on the work of the Lord. And meeting his physical needs. Hallelujah. And now he says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. No time to judge my brother. No time to condemn my sister. I place a premium, I place value and weight on my salvation because Jesus went to the cross at Calvary. He shed his blood. He suffered pain and agony and he gave up his life for me. Themselves in murmurings and disputations with which amount to hypocrisy that is unprofitable to the soul. Amen. And when you really check the record, the people who do the most murmuring and complaining and disputing are the most unfaithful.
Come on, Bishop.
In spiritual things of the church and in carnal things of the church. And I'm talking about tithes and offerings. Kept his word. So now, seek to be disingenuous to the grace of God. Because grace means so much to me. For by grace are you saved through faith, and not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Paul declared, I do not frustrate the grace of God.
No.
People who are filled with the joy of the Lord do not frustrate the grace of God.
Hallelujah.
The text goes on, do all things without murmurings and disputings.
Yes,
that you may be blameless, and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom you shine as lights in the world.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Simply put, if you are a murmurer, complainer, disputer, according to this, you're not blameless. You're not harmless. You're not the sons of God. You're not without rebuke. Oh Lord, have mercy.
That's right.
Holding forth the word of life. Amen. Can I tell you today that the life we live in the world, it has to be balanced with the word of life that we get in the world. Holding forward the word of God.
That's right,
must be balanced. That I may rejoice in the day of Christ, that I have not run in vain, neither labored in vain. No sensible church leader would want at the end of his tenure or her tenure to see the word fall down.
No.
51 years. Licensed minister. 58 years of working in the Church of God. 13 years of district overseer. Many, many years in national evangelism. Do you want to see Megwana fall?
No.
Now that you're out of office?
No.
Do I want to see the Bahamas work crumble? What do you have to face?
Yes.
But the love and the passion for the work at Philippi, Macedonia was so strong. Hallelujah. That from his jail cell, he is encouraging the people of God, his converts, those who will be ministered to, those who will be mentored to, those who will be taught and instructed and helped and blessed. We allow them to slip away. Jesus taught, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit shall remain. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Nothing could be more beautiful than seeing the steadfastness of the saints.
Yes, amen.
You know, when you travel the Bahamas and beyond the Bahamas, and you go to congregations and places, you want to see the steadfastness of the people.
Yes.
Of course, you will see new people, but you want to see the steadfastness of the stalwarts.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Because when we
we are saved.
I kept them in thy name.
Yes, sir.
Those that thou gavest me, I have kept.
Yes, yes.
Keeping the people of God together is important.
Yes.
None of them is lost.
None.
Except
one.
Just one. The son of perdition.
Yes, sir.
And why? That the scriptures scripture that we need to be fulfilled in our lives, that we've been faithful to the end.
Yeah.
Judas is gone.
Yeah.
Iscariot is gone.
Yeah.
But we are still here.
Yeah.
And we need to make our calling and our election sure.
Yeah.
We need to retain the joy of the Lord. Keep it bubbling day and night.
Yeah.
Because the more joyful we are, the more
that's right.
Ask God if it was easy.
That's right. Is it serious, Bishop?
Doing the work of the Lord, we come up against an adversary whose intent is to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes,
but work on we must.
Yes, sir.
Do I have a witness?
Yes, sir.
Business for his intentions are.
Amen.
But we are the king's business.
Hallelujah.
And wake on, we must. Hallelujah.
Bless him, Lord.
And we wake on because greater is he that is in us.
Yes.
And that's why we should not give too much credence to the devil.
No.
Amen. Because the joy of the Lord shall be your strength.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
That's
and be not weary in well doing, people of God.
Yes.
For new season you shall reap.
Yes.
If it faint not.
Yes.
At times the persecution and suffering might bring us to tears.
Yes.
How many of you have ever cried in this work?
Yes.
But the Apostle Paul called the burden of the work the care of the churches. And each of us in our own respective way, we have got the care and the burden. We feel this work. I don't care who you are. If you don't feel the pressure of this work, something is wrong with you. There is no devil after you. But let me tell you, if you are real and genuine, the devil is after you. And you will feel the frustrations and the pressures of this work from time to time. It will bring you to tears.
Amen.
Hallelujah. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. You see how it goes? The devil may make you shed some tears. But they're going to reap in joy.
Hallelujah.
It's the end that counts.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Reaping in joy. Going forth and weeping, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him, not leaving them behind. But the joy is in keeping those whom you want to the Lord. So I want to keep my wife, I want to keep my daughters and my son. I want to keep the thousands whom the Lord has privileged me to bring to the body of Christ and to the kingdom of God, because there's going to be a great day of rejoicing. Hallelujah. Oh, what singing. Oh, what shouting. Oh, So to the faithful, there is no vanity or waste of time in the wake of the Lord. Some things we do in this life, it's a waste of time.
Yes, yes.
No merit.
Yes. True, true.
No pity. No profit. Waste of time.
Oh my God.
There is a guaranteed reward for the faithful.
Yes.
Hold on to the end. Guaranteed. This reward is not like the lottery jackpot reserved for just a lucky few. My Lord. God have mercy. I know this is a bad subject to touch on.
That's what the Lord gave me. That's all right.
Just a lucky few. No matter the millions of dollars in the lottery, the jackpot. So it's reserved for the lucky few. But praise God in this business that we are in, in this work that we are in. Hallelujah. There is a guaranteed reward. The power of life is not for a lucky few. The power of life is for all who are faithful in Jesus Christ. Said you've got your award down here, but now the reward is over.